Kalighat, the unmistakable landmark of the city. The city known as Calcutta or Kolkata, or now as Kolkata. Kalighat derives its name from the Kali Khetro, the ground of Kali, a hallowed Hindu pilgrimage in eastern India. The temple that stands today on the sacred ground was built in 1809 by the Shaburno Chaudhuris, a family of zamindars who ruled the land occupied by the city. British maps of Calcutta in 1759 show that the temple stands on an ancient road to the pilgrimage in the so-called Black Town of the native quarters. With generations of pilgrims, a roadside bazaar also grew up with historical inevitability. It was in this bazaar that the famous Kalighat school of painting and drawing prospered. The Kalighat port became part of a great visual and iconographic tradition. The port painters reigned over the roadside bazaar for almost 75 years, from the second quarter of the 19th century to the first quarter of the 20th. These urban painters themselves migrated from their rural origins in Medinipur, Birbhum, Murshidabad, and the 24 Parganas. Originally, they belonged to the community of scroll painters who practiced a typical style of painting on rolls of paper with a cloth backing. Some of them were also painters of the shora, a round terracotta vessel used as a plaque. The market for the Kalighat pots grew with time, as more and more pilgrims flocked to the temple round the year. The pot painters also changed their style as they changed their residence. The rolled-up scrolls gave way to the square paper of the pot. The basic materials of the Kalighat pot evolved as folio-sized paper began being manufactured in Srirampur during the 19th century. The mass-produced paper was cheap and readily available, and its smooth surface absorbed watercolours very easily. The painter's brush could move smoothly and softly over the surface. The basic drawing was executed with one long sweep of the brush, without the faintest hesitation or momentary indecision, or even the slightest tremor of the hand. Often, the basic line transcribed the entire figure in such a way that it challenged the viewer to find out where the line had begun and where it had ended. The artists were inspired by Bengal's clay modeling traditions, imparting to their figures a monumental quality and an illusion of roundness that was delivered with traditional artistry and immaculate care. The characteristics of portraiture emphasized a straight and narrow nose, rounded chin, soft lips, arched eyebrows, and large expressive eyes. Kalighat pots also included shading for the effect of roundness or relief, executed in a manner determined by age-old tradition. The effect of shading was created by sweeping a wet brush soaked in watercolor or partially damped paper. The style of the Kalighat pot painters was distinctively different from the two-dimensional folk paintings because of their use of the third dimension. The pot painters displayed a rich sense of innovation and originality in their choice of color. They used opaque pigments with an oxide or arsenic base rather than tempera. These pigments were made from indigenous ingredients, peyuri, shindur, flumin, and other herbal products were the materials. Lamp suit was another major ingredient. Their brushes were homemade, manufactured from the hair of sheep, squirrels, or goat tails. The European painters who came with the East India Company, or company painters as they are called, also influenced the Kalighat style. The wash technique created the effect of volume. The highly individualized and stylistic content of the Kalighat pots was certainly achieved through the confluence of three distinct major influences: the Bengal folk paintings, the Western style, and the Indian school of art. The Kalighat pot painters achieved the height of their prowess and popularity between 1845 to 1871. Calcutta was linked to other parts of the country by the railways, and this significantly increased the number of pilgrims to the Kalighat temple. It contributed to a quantum leap for the pot market. Sold as a souvenir of the pilgrimage to the temple, many Kalighat pots had the presiding Hindu deities as their subject. Unlike other artistic traditions or schools of art in India, the Kalighat painters gave full rein to their individual imagination and creativity. While other traditions of schools have remained unchanged in time, Kalighat created a body of visual art that was stylistically specific in the context of the time and space of its growth. In the course of time, however, the street painters broadened their search for themes. Social satire, directed against Calcutta's nouveau riche and the middle classes, including self-indulgent babus, local dandies, their scandals, their hypocrisies, Brahmin double standards, and the elegant courtesans of the city, entered the world of the Kalighat port. Kalighat ports of the time were a vivid reflection of the emerging urban scenario, portrayed with liveliness and integrity. The erotica that they created about the activities of the decadent babus of Calcutta and their women of ill repute served as spin-ups of their time, satirical, humorous, and enjoyable even today. The famous Tarukeshwar scandal in 1873 was one that shook the foundations of the Bengali society of the time. A local housewife of Tarukeshwar called Elokeshi, famed for her breathtaking beauty, was escorted to Madhobgiri, the chief priest of the temple here. The Kalighat painters did not lose time to depict the sensational incident in their work. Besotted by her, Madhogiri pleaded with her to become his mistress. And Elokeshi agreed. It did not take long for her husband, Nobin, to find out the truth from the neighbors. Ultimately, Elokeshi realized her transgression and asked for Nobin's forgiveness.
Dubilam kapal doshe dilam tumar kule kali dilam tumar kule kali kolonko desh bideshe dilam tumar kule kali kolonko desh bideshe oshad khawaba chale oshad khawabar chale mohanto amar shotito nashile bolte nayon jale bhashe bolte nayon jale bhashe eki desha hola amar eki
An angry Nobin, however, killed Elokeshi to avenge himself. Madhogiri was sentenced to long, rigorous imprisonment for adultery at the end of a prolonged and sensational trial. It was eventually technology that challenged the Kalighat painters. Cheap reproductions by the new lithographic press in Calcutta and reproductions imported from Germany endangered their existence. Even the inexpensive woodcut block prints that emerged from the Bortthala area contributed to the slow but steady decline. By the 20th century, it was the mechanical reproduction of the visual image that destroyed the Kalighat port, till it finally disappeared in the 1930s. Time and technology have not left the Kalighat port a living urban folk tradition. But the work of the unsophisticated yet skilled painters of Kalighat, created during their time, has lived on, to be appreciated by art enthusiasts throughout the world. By these artists, all of whom belonged to the lower economic strata, leaves the body of Kalighat ports as an example of people's art. Their subaltern visual imagination contributed monumentally to the work of great Bengal artists like Jamini Rai and others. Their boldness in concept and execution, their satiric wit, their daring brushstrokes, and the brilliant use of the third dimension have left them a unique place in the history of art the world over. That they emerged out of an urban experience with the rural tradition makes them all the more unique. Today, a Kalighat pot of quality is part of heritage, a contemporary artist's inspiration, a connoisseur collector's item, and the people's delight.